gate. But as they reached the gate, they saw a crowd of people draw near. It was Jesus with his 12 apostles and others who had followed him here. When the Lord saw the mourners with the bier and the widow walking beside, his heart was touched by her sorrow and pain. So he said to her, "Don't cry." The people heard Jesus speaking to her as they stopped there on the road. Then the Lord himself came closer to them and touched their heavy load. "Young man, I say to you, get up," the Lord said to the boy. And that's exactly what he did as his mother cried with joy. Then Jesus took the young man's hand as the son got up and walked. Then Jesus gave him to his mom and they hugged and kissed and talked. The people there who witnessed this were shocked and filled with awe. They celebrated this miracle and sang their praises to God. "A prophet has come to us," they said. "He is surely someone great. God has come to help us all. Let's spread the word. Don't wait." And so the news of this great miracle was spread from town to town.
They heard it throughout Judea and in the country all around, that Jesus had raised the widow's son, had brought him back to life. This showed his power over death and revealed that he was the Christ.
And still today, the news is spread. It's carried around the world. In every land and every tongue, God's message is unfurled.
Because Jesus, our Lord, is Christ the King, over Satan, Christ won the fight,
defeating death,
forgiving our sins,
and giving us eternal life. A stray puppy sat quietly in the corner while a group of boys was laughing and talking. Then the pastor walked up and said, "What's happening?" A six-year-old boy replied and said, "We're telling lies, and whoever tells the biggest lie wins this little puppy." The pastor replied with a disapproving look, "That's a horrible way to decide who gets the puppy. When I was your age, I never lied." Then the six-year-old boy picked up the puppy and handed it to the pastor. "Here, I guess you win the dog." And now it's time for a trio for my very lovely sisters.
Hallelujah, I'm ready to go. Hallelujah, I'm ready. I'm ready.
guys were riding in a car. The driver came up to a stoplight and cruised right through it. "What are you doing?" asked his buddy. "It's okay. My brother does it all the time," assured the driver. Then they came to another red light, and they went right through that one, too.
"You must be crazy," said his buddy.
"Really, it's okay. My brother does it all the time," said the driver. Then they came to a green light, and the driver stopped.
"It's green," his buddy said. "Aren't you gonna go?"
The driver replied, "Are you crazy? My brother might be coming." Back with her viola, here's my sister Lydia with a medley of a Gaither song called "I'm Feeling Fine" and the hymn "When We All Get to Heaven."
Thank you.
godly in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution.
But evil men and impostors will grow worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived.
You, however, must remain faithful in what you have learned,
in the things of which you are certain,
knowing from whom you have learned them,
and that from childhood you have known the Holy Scriptures,
which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith,
which is in Christ Jesus.
All Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine,
for reproof,
for correction,
for instruction in righteousness,
that the man of God may be complete,
thoroughly equipped for every good work.
I charge you therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ,
who will judge the living
and the dead
at his appearing
and his kingdom.
Preach the word.
Be at it when it is and when it is not convenient.
Convince, rebuke,
exhort with all the patience that the work of teaching requires.
For the time will come
when people won't listen to the truth, but according to their own desires,
to satisfy their own fancies,
they will heap up for themselves teachers,
and they will turn their ears away from the truth
and be turned aside to fable. But you be watchful in all things.
Endure afflictions.
Work to spread the gospel.
Fulfill your ministry.
Can anybody guess what one of my favorite things about the fair is? That is correct. One of my favorite things about the fair is the food. And I am so thankful that God made food.
Breakfast, supper time, snack.
Dear God, I thank you that everybody here got to praise and worship you today. And I pray if anybody here isn't saved, that they will make you their Lord and Savior. And help us to be your light. In Jesus' name, amen.